Assalamualaikum student, this is eSoft Learning Java Swing tutorial lecture number 20. Today I'm going to show you how to insert image into database and retrieve back. Now let's start it. Let's run our form to see. That we need a click of the particular student data, that image also show, that's we click in the saw, that's Emma, John, Tishu, that your data is also show in these check boxes. And here we take a picture fan that shows then image also for the particular students. So for that, first of all, save data manually into the database. In the later lecture, inshallah, I will teach you how to save directly from your form into the database these images. Now in your table, first of all, you add a new row with the image, modify table, add fields. From add fields, that's you fill here, it's name is image, and that's already slow, and that integer type is blob. Blob is for fracture, saves the binary data. So remove it now. Okay, that you see, that's this image underscore. Now by double clicked here, you enter the image. Now it's, I want to enter text, then I double clicked, so I enter here, and now I that's ishme, that in the image field. Now I double click here, that's the image import. That's you want to import from anything thing inside your in your computer. That is my images, select one of them, that and okay, that is the image. That's the noun. I want to select the image for Ahmad, double click import, and that right here click images, select one of the Ahmad, open. And the okay, that's Ahmad Pikmin. Then you select that images for your whole data here. That's all are that I already selected these images, so I don't want to need that. And if you want to select these images, after that you click on right changes here, that's save your database data. After that, you go to your design and add here to the desktop pen. It is a desktop pen. Right here, or now right here, a text. Let's right click on that, change variable name l underscore image, level underscore image. Okay, and now edit text, remove your text from here. Good. Sure. Now let's go to your table mouse click event, the table mouse click event. That are so I already write this code in the previous lecture. You see my previous lecture, I already show that's how the J table data shift into the JTX field by mouse click. Let's, I will show you. that's when I click at this data, add shift into these JTX fields that I already show you in our previous lecture. So this is the code for now. I use this code to retrieve pictures from database by mouse click. So first of all, I cut these two lines from here and paste it. At the top here, these as a run JTable dot get selected row, it get the most clicked value into in our variable table underscore click. So we want in these image caches. So for that purpose, I write here at the top of my code. After then, I write a try. Cache block, and here copy cache block from here, and of instead of the J option pane dot show dialogs E, I write E dot print stack. E dot print stack tree. Showing this, I also copies these SQL query, this PST prepared statement query, and that's RS dot next here. Copy and paste it here. Now, I write some changes in my query. Write the instead of static, I just retrieve image field. Select image from TBL underscore student where name is equal to table click valued. Then, and what's in the field I clicked that in the particular student's picture shown in the desktop pane. So in the variable table underscore click, I save my mouse clicked value. That you see the format return underscore single colon underscore golden colon plus PST con dot prepare statement SQL and PST dot execute query. I already explained these PST and result sets in my previous lectures. So in the RS dot next, I write some code for retrieving the image from database. So I take a variable byte. I just name an image data. Image data. To that's I store in the image data. That's whatsoever retrieve in my result set. So write RS dot get byte. In this field, in if you see in your database, that's it's the image field, their name image. So and the double colon, I write database field name, it is image. That's now I store my database by data in the image data variable. Now I for saving image in the plant I used it image icon format in image 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 icon format is equal to new image icon. New image, it is a image data. That's it's want to import the java.swing.image icon. So I import it. Let's remove that error. So retrieving the image into the image variable, byte variable. No, I for it's retrieving from database, and that's image icon that's format image icon variable I took for showing your image in your form. So if you will see a level lbl underscore image, I append my image to this label. Its name is lbl underscore image dot set icon. It's format. Now that is the code. So run it to check what will be happen. Now I check it, that saw that you get saw the picture is displayed. Now I check it, that Ahmad picture is displayed here. Now I click on John, that's John is displayed here. Now the Wajid, that's Wajid is displayed. That's you see, you click that also data shift in the JTX field and its picture corresponding to that student is also showing here. So just overview the code. We in an integer row, gender row dot selected row, we get a selected row here, and from these selected rows I took the data by mouse click and the table and score text data at its value. Now I put a condition on this table underscore text to retrieve the image from database, and they use this PST statement or RS statement. I took my data in save to image variable. Its type is byte, and for the front end I stored this image byte into format variable and set these to the label icon. So enjoy it, inshallah. In the next lecture I will teach you how to save, update and delete this picture from the front end. Till then, Allah Hafiz.